Hello and welcome to In My Opinion from Rune Factory, Tides of Destiny. We join our two protagonists, Aiden and Sanja, as they take out some nonsense and then cleanse the shrine. With what else? The power of song. Afterwards, they are then sucked into a bright light and appear in a world that looks like theirs, but isn't. They are then found by one of the town folk. They also realize that they now share the same body. Their goal is to now figure out how to separate from one another and also stop an evil masked dude who's been messing up all the shrines while interacting with all the town folk. And that's pretty much the story of the game. Of course, it's a little more talking here and there, but that's about it. The game is basically a farming action RPG relationship simulator. Man, what a mouthful. But it actually works pretty well. You collect monsters by brushing them instead of smacking them with your weapons. They then in turn work for you. You have different islands which are represented in different types of seasons in which to grow your crops, such as corn and tomatoes and others, to use as ingredients to cook food to eat, which give you a stat boost or sell. You also grow trees to craft stuff like chairs, flowers that you could give as gifts or use as materials. Also, you can mine diamonds, gold, and such for building weapons. You can even fish if you feel like it. It's a nice way to earn some cash without losing any. There are different dungeons to tackle. Each dungeon has multiple floors and finally a boss fight. One of the bosses being a kickboxing croc with what I think is an Australian accent. Weird, huh? The weapons come in forms of big swords, dual blades, wands, spears, hammers, and even a katana. The more you use a certain weapon type, the more it levels up, unlocking more attacks such as sword surfing on your giant sword. Each weapon could also have a rune ability, which can be something like a lightning attack or just running faster. While that sounds cool, the combat itself, to be honest, is just serviceable. It's nothing deep and the lack of a lock-on can get pretty annoying, especially when you get gangbanged in the corner by multiple foes. And since to use a healing item causes an animation that leaves you wide open, it can become more of a headache. Though the more types of monsters you kill, the more you become stronger against those types. So with that in mind, and a combination of leveling up in general, eventually you'll be mowing them down. Also, there's a giant golem you can ride in order to navigate the world and dig for islands and even get into kaiju-style battles. Now, the other big part of the game is relationship building with the colorful cast of characters. You build up your relationship meter by giving them gifts, talking to them,
it's great to see ya.
These requests can be things like finding an island, giving someone an item, or just talking to someone. There are even festivals the town holds that can help raise your meter, like a swimsuit contest for the ladies. You can also check your calendar to see when these festivals take place, and even check for birthdays to get extra points when you give gifts. This in turn lets you find out more about the character's personality and history. If you get their meter high enough, you can trigger romantic moments with certain characters. These romantic moments can be really sweet and a bit corny at times, like this one.
Because I love you.
Do you feel the same way about me?
But I'm a dark elf.
Dark
elf or human, it doesn't matter. You're the woman for me. And I love you.
You love me? Truly?
Didn't you say that you came to be a bridge between dark elves and humans? You and I as a couple wouldn't be a bad example of that.
I always thought that love between a dark elf and a human was impossible. So, when I started feeling something for you, I just tried to hide it. But now I'm happy. So happy. I love you too. From now on, I'm your woman, and you're my man. I'll never, ever let you go. What's this? Huh?
Aw, ain't that sweet? Reaching full romance level, you can date and then marry a character, which can result in getting pregnant and having a kid. You can have these moments with Aiden or Sanja. Yes, folks, you can play as a female lead as well. There are 10 females for Aiden to romance, and 4 males for Sanja to romance. Yeah, the difference in number is a bit unfair for those who want to be Sanja, but hey, you take what you can get. I will admit, I got addicted to seeing all the romance moments for the characters. However, these moments can't be reached until you finish this main storyline. As you can tell by looking at this game, it's not some graphics powerhouse, although I will say the game is still pleasing to the eyes. Each character is varied and the town itself changes for each season the game has. The dungeons as well vary in look and sound. Some may be turned off by the big anime eyes, constant smiling, and a whole lot of blushing. But I wasn't bothered by it at all. This could be that it has an anime look to it, and well, I enjoy my anime. In the end, nothing amazing looking, but it doesn't cause your eyes to bleed.
There is some voice acting in this game, as you can tell. Most of it is nicely acted, though there are points for some reason the music of the game would turn louder than the vocal dialogue, mainly when Aiden speaks. Town music is nice and fitting, and same goes for the dungeons. This was my first time getting into the Rune Factory series. I felt being my first game in the series, it's a nice jumping point with a fun cast. I put a close 200 hours in this game and it never felt like a drag. I recommend it for those who are curious about the series, but felt free to dive in. The game's main plot is just okay. The combat is, like I said, serviceable but annoying at times. But everything else is enjoyable and addicting. I've now become interested in the series and can't wait to play the upcoming releases. I hope you enjoyed my thoughts on this game, and for gamer's sake, keep gaming.
その君の笑った顔明日へと繋げる気はきっと見つかるおそこで荷物置いて力も抜いたなら一緒にこうスローでいいから君と行きたい次のステージ